Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Moore.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And welcome to another edition of To Tell the Truth. Very, very glad to have you with us. And as you can see, I am not unaccompanied. Would you tell our audience what your name is, please?
Leroy Ross.
Now, as you can see, Leroy is right. Leroy, what is the name of that thing you're riding?
Unicycle,
huh? Well, now, we've all seen unicycles at one time or another, but obviously he does something rather extraordinary from it. Leroy, what do you do that's different?
Play basketball.
You play basketball?
Yes.
Well, I want to tell you, oh, you're out here. I want to tell you that you got to see this, and you're going to see it in just a minute. That was Leroy. And you're going to see it in just a minute as soon as we've met our somewhat dizzy panel here on To Tell the Truth.
Peggy Cass. Bill Cullen. Carlisle. And Nipsey Russell.
Here's a man. He would have brought a whole bike, but in New York there's only room to park one wheel at a time, so he would only bring half of it. Nipsey, your fate is to always get stuck with a poem for our audience. I trust you have one today.
A word of philosophy.
Philosophy.
Help a man when he is in trouble. Help him and never complain. Help him and he will remember you when he is in trouble again.
Yeah. Am I right?
On the nose. Absolutely on the nose. All righty, now let's follow up the gentleman you met earlier and meet another extraordinary basketball player.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Charles King.
Number two.
My name is Charles King.
Number three.
My name is Charles King.
And of course, the way the game is played is two of them are not telling the truth. But one of them really is Charles King, and here is his fast-moving story. He says, I, Charles King, play basketball on a unicycle. As one of the founders of the King Charles troupe, I perform on a razzle-dazzle 10-man squad in what has to be the world's most unique basketball game. Here we are in action.
My gosh.
As the story continues, it says, touring with Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus, we perform at high schools, poverty program centers, and other social institutions. As to how we play ball while madly whirling and twisting on unicycles, well, why don't you stick around, because later on in the program, a couple of us will give you an in-person sample of our spectacular artistry. Signed, Charles King. And while they make themselves comfortable on the chairs over there, we're going to check with our sponsor, see what he's got in mind, and be right back. We have across from us three accomplished gentlemen, all claiming to be Charles King, the leader of a unicycling basketball team. And I think only right that we start with our esteemed sports specialist, Kitty Carlisle.
Well, I'm glad you asked me first, because I am indeed a bicycle rider. And so I'd like to ask some very searching questions. Number three.
How many wheels are there on a bicycle?
Are your pedals locked to the wheel as they are on an ordinary bike, or are they free-floating, so to speak? Can you coast?
Well, no, you can't coast on it. You can't coast on it. The wheels.
They are locked in. Yeah. And number two, were you a basketball player first, or were you a cyclist first?
I was a cyclist first.
And you, number one?
Cyclist first.
I see. And number three, how did you come to this? By the way, did I see you fall off, one of you fall off the bike when you were trying to put the ball in the basket?
You didn't see me fall off.
Did I see number two? Did I see someone fall off?
I hope not, but you could have.
Number one, is that considered a penalty in your game?
Yes, it is.
What happens? What do you lose if you fall off?
You lose the person that fell off.
And if you lose five of them, it gets to be a very one-sided game. Let's go down to Peggy Cass, please. Oh, I'm sorry, Nipsey.
This way.
Beg your pardon, friend, yeah.
Number one, when your organization first came into existence, they went on a television show, a talk show. Which one was it?
It was I've Got a Secret.
I've Got a Secret.
And then we went on Johnny Carson.
I see. Number two, what constitutes a double dribble in your game?
Just like, you know, when you're playing regulation basketball, you take the ball and you, with both hands, you're in trouble. Yeah. Same thing as a regular basketball game. You can only dribble with one hand.
I see. Number three, at one time, one of the members of your group came to my hotel and asked me about getting him on a show. Do you remember what hotel it was?
No, I don't.
The fellow who was doing the publicity for your group, not one of the players.
That came to see about getting us on a TV program?
Right.
No, I don't, but I remember,
All right, let's go down Peggy Cass.
Number one, what's a pick?
A pick?
Yeah.
I really don't know.
Oh, okay. Number two, are you bunched up into, do you have regular guards and forwards the way they do in professional basketball?
Exactly.
Thank you. Number three, do you play other teams? I mean, is there a UBA, Unicycle Basketball Association?
No, not yet. Okay. But we play each other.
Thank you. Well, number one, what other teams do you play? Just your team has 10 guys?
Right. In the circus, there's 10 of us. In the circus, we play each other. And during rehearsals or in breaks, we play high schools and different organizations for benefits.
Okay. Well, number two, if a guy has 5 personal fouls, who comes in to play for him when he's out, or don't you get 5 personal fouls?
You get 5 personal fouls, but you have to remember that it would be like an exhibition game, more like the Harlem Globetrotter style.
I see. Okay. Number three, what's a hook shot?
Well, that's when you...
Huh? I missed it. You gotta do it again.
2 points.
You weren't watching? It's when you... Yeah. Like that. Same as Lawrence Welk. Bill?
Hookshot made a nice noise. Number three, how many... You mentioned that when you're at the circus, you play among yourselves, and you play other teams when you're on tour. How many unicycle basketball teams are there in the country?
Well, we don't play other teams. Like, we play among ourselves when we do these exhibitions at high schools and different... poverty centers and things like that. As far as I know, there's a lot of little groups that are coming along, but nothing like us. We are the kings, that's all.
Yeah, the King Charles. Number one, is it true that there are groups springing up and other teams that do play on unicycles?
Yes, there is.
And where is mostly do you find these, in the Midwest?
There's a lot, and there's 2 in Pittsburgh and 1 in Syracuse.
I came from Pittsburgh, it explains that. Number two, what's an...
All right, there goes the little ding-dong. Friends, I reluctantly cut off your questioning, and it's time now for us to vote. Who do we think it is? Number one, or number two, or number three? We pay $50 for each wrong guess. We pay $500 if nobody comes up with the right Charles King. And Kitty starts, please.
Well, I think it's a very amusing idea, and I'll bet it's fun to watch. So I voted for number one because he's an amusing guy.
All righty, good enough. We got a one showing. And
I was about to go with number one, too, but if I remember correctly, their first TV appearance was on the Merv Griffin Show. I happened to be there that night. So I went for number two because I just don't remember number three at all.
All righty, you got one and a two, and Peggy showing.
Well, number one may be amusing, but if he doesn't know the pick, I don't think he knows how to play basketball.
I didn't know what that was either.
And I don't know, I have a feeling it's number three. Number two seems more of a businessman than a basketball player.
All right, you got them all down the line. Everybody's got one. Bill Cullen, somebody's going to have 2.
Yeah, number one had a little trouble with a pick, and number two had trouble with a double dribble. I have trouble with a double dribble, too, but I voted for number three.
All righty. 3 has the majority. The votes are in. Will the real Charles King please stand up? Nipsey's got him.
Yeah.
Charles. While we find out about your two imposters, why don't you go backstage and get your equipment lined up and get Leroy, and he's going to give us an exhibition of how this thing is done. But let's find out about number one. Number one, what is your real name? What do you do?
My name is Howard Burton, and I'm a disc jockey for WSYR Radio in Syracuse, New York.
Hey, good luck, friend. And number three, tell us about you.
My name is Woody Henderson. I'm a comedian from Chicago with the Electric Crazy People and a fashion model with Black Beauty in New York.
Ah, that's clever. Well, now we are going to see this thing done, and of course, the regular scoring in real life is like it is in a basketball game, but in this case, what we're going to do is the first fella to score a goal is the winner of the game. Leroy Ross. Hips. 1 point takes the game. See him dribble away from him. And they must shoot while on the unicycle. Doesn't count. He's disqualified, but we got to keep him on anyhow. Else it'd just be Leroy all by himself. Here comes Leroy out of the wings. And, oh, he's got a perfect shot there. There you go. Now let's say hello to our Dracula devotee.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Leonard Wolf.
Number two.
My name is Leonard Wolf.
Number three.
My name is Leonard Wolf.
Great name for the guy. Here is Leonard Wolf's blood-sucking saga. He says, I, Leonard Wolf, am the author of a book called A Dream of Dracula. In it, I tell of the historic Dracula, who is credited with the brutal murder of thousands, and of the famed Transylvania account of fiction and of films. I'm interested in Dracula as more than a rousing horror tale. To me, he symbolizes the darkest reaches of the human experience. From the blood-drinking Indian goddess Kali to the excesses of today's Hell's Angels, the impulse to foul deeds is part of man's subconscious. In the course of my research for my book, I managed to meet a modern-day Dracula, a young man who is turned on to human blood drinking and who finds victims willing and anxious to cooperate. Perhaps one of the reasons that Dracula is so fascinating to me is that I myself was born in Transylvania. Signed, Leonard Wolf. And I don't want to tip anything off, but after this spot is over, the real one has got a demonstration for Kitty and for Peggy that you wouldn't believe. Yeah. And let's start the questioning with Nipsey, please.
My first question is the number two. Where do you find victims willing and eager to participate in this blood-sucking thing?
I don't find them. It's the man I interviewed for the book. He finds them.
Well, is he the sucker or the sucky?
He is the sucker.
I see. Dracula number three.
Great.
What religion is Dracula? I've noticed in the films I've seen, they've always confronted him with a crucifix, and this has more or less been his undoing.
He is a citizen of the world.
Of the world. Is still number three, is Transylvania a country or a concept?
It's a part of a country.
What's the country?
Part of Romania.
I see. Number one.
Thank you, Nipsey. Great question. Let's go down to Peggy.
Now listen, fellas, about this demonstration, it's okay for Kitty, but I'm anemic. You wouldn't like me a bit. Okay, now, number one, by the dark reaches of the mind or the soul or whatever, do you mean the id?
Yes, we do.
And who was it that really discovered the id?
The id was discovered in 1831.
By whom?
It is part of Count Dracula, the author.
Thank you. Now, number three, I don't like to disillusion you about this blood and everything, but the Hell's Angels drink beer. I mean, they're big beer drinkers. I don't think they drink blood.
That is true.
Well, then, why do you think they are in the darkest reaches? I mean, what is...
They drink... they have been known to do things that we cannot mention on the air.
You mean the unspeakable?
Unspeakable things.
Oh, my, can I see you later?
Not me. Now,
number two, are you a psychologist?
No, I am not.
Thank you. Well, number three, do you believe that everybody, every person in the world has these terrible, deep, subconscious yearnings to do terrible things?
Most people.
Speak for yourself, John.
Let's go to Bill Cullen, please.
Yeah, I don't understand about the Hells Angels because I'm a typical red-blooded American boy, and I've done a lot of things that I wouldn't mention on the air. And I think that goes for all of us, too.
Not me.
Or at least not describe in detail. Number two, you mentioned this fellow you interviewed was a fellow who actually drank human blood. Is that true?
That's true.
Is there no chance, number two, that this fellow, whoever he might be, is putting you on?
No chance at all.
How did you... All right, I'll go to number one, just to mix it up a little bit. How did you authenticate what he told you, number one, the people who you interviewed?
We found him, and they brought him in, and I was there at the time that it happened.
Well, number three, isn't drinking human blood from a live human being against the law?
I'm not a lawyer.
Well, I mean, aren't you apt to get a ticket for that or something?
Pull over okay, to the
drinking
curb.
Human blood.
Drinking blood on Fifth Avenue. Yeah, okay. That's no kidding. You got a chance.
Number one, did your name Wolf lead you to this investigation?
It sounds like it would have. Actually, I've been fascinated through old horror movies.
I see. Number two, I read a book about Dracula once, and there was a famous countess. I think she was Hungarian. Isn't Transylvania also partly in Hungary?
Transylvania used to be in the Austro-Hungarian Empire.
Thank
it's
you.
Now in Romania.
May I ask you another question, number two? Do you remember this this countess from Transylvania who drank all these young girls' blood, and hundreds of young girls were found in her castle? Do you remember her name?
Yes.
What was it?
Her name is Elizabeth Bathory.
Thank you. Number two, this modern-day fellow, did he bring his victim in with him when you watched this happen? Or did he bring his blood in a glass? Number three, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Oh, forgive me. Did he bring it in a glass, or did he bring it like the cow? You know, he brought it in with him.
Neither way.
How did he do it?
Called room service.
Oh, what a time for the bell to ring. But the bell rang, and that means no more questions. It is time now for them to vote and for you and I to decide what we think. Who do you like, number one, or number two, or number three? And Nipsey, I see you got your ballot marked. I assume there are reasons.
Yes. Number three is or should be a dramatic actor. He certainly has a marvelous quality for that. I just went for number one because he was the least in volunteering his information, and for that reason I thought he might just be the most mysterious.
All righty, so you got a one, and we're going down to Peggy.
Yeah, but number one didn't know anything about the id. He said it was discovered in 1836. He never mentioned Freud or anything, so I passed him by. I was going to vote for you, number three, because I think you're really just terrific. But number two knew about Elizabeth Pathological, and so I voted for him.
All right, you got one and two. Bill Cullen.
Yeah, well, I didn't vote for number three because he seemed to sound like a vampire. And I assumed if he were, he would hide it until he got us, you know, in the call room service for a cup of blood or something like that. Anyway, number one is the all-American vampire. I didn't vote for him. I voted for number two.
All right, so you've got it. One, two, two. Skitty, how are you going?
Number two knew about Countess Bathory, and that is the lady.
That's right.
If you can call her a lady. And so I voted for him.
All righty, that's the way it goes over here. The votes are in with the real Leonard Wolf. Please stand up, sir. It's number one. No, it's number two. Good shot. Good shot. Let's find out about who our friends are. Number one, what is your real name, please, and what do you do?
I'm John Swenis with Swenis Hedin Advertising, Osseo, Minnesota.
Good to have you here, John. Number three, you sounded like an Americanized Bela Lugosi. What is your real name?
My real name is Alan Buck. I'm a placement manager for VIP Associates.
All right. Leonard.
brought his...
Oh, yeah, how did you... Leonard, how did you actually authenticate the fellow who drank blood? Did you see this happen?
He did it before my eyes.
With a human being?
With a human being.
Oh. From where?
Through the neck.
Pardon?
The neck?
From the arm.
From the arm.
Oh, wow.
I was not eating. He can
take it. He can take it from the neck, yeah. And he does.
Well, I think I heard about as much as I want to hear, and I thank you very much, Leonard. I appreciate your being here, gentlemen. And so, speaking on behalf of the panel and of the King Charles Trio and of Count Dracula, we bid you a fond farewell. We'll see you again at midnight.
This is Bill Wendell speaking for To Tell the Truth on Mark Goodson, Bill Tuck Production. Oh.